Hey, in this video, we will discuss together a question on prime numbers. I've already recorded a video on the main concepts that prime numbers have. If you haven't watched that yet, use this link to watch that and come back here. If you're already solid with your concepts, let's get going on this question journey. So here's our question. A positive integer x has 4 prime factors and 16 total factors. So there's a difference between these 4 prime factors. These are just the prime factors, say a 2 or a 3 or a 5 or a 7, etc., and 16 total factors. Total factors include the prime factors as well as 1, the number itself, or any other composite factor that your number might have. Now, with this information about x, these 2 pieces of information, I have to tell something about x to the power m, that how many factors that has. Let's see how we approach such questions. So we'll use it piece by piece, everything given to us in the question. Let's take one bit and understand it. So first I'm given that x has 4 prime factors. Now if it has 4 prime factors, I can use this fact to write the prime factorization of x like this. Here p1, p2, p3, p4 will be the prime factors that x has with their respective powers a, b, c, and d. And it has a total of 16 factors. Now, this is something we covered in the concepts. How do you get the total factors that a number has from its prime factorization? So what you have to do is you have to increase each of the powers, A, B, C, D in my case, increase them by 1 and multiply these increased numbers. So since I know total number of factors here for me is 16, I can just equate this to 16. So it's a product of 4 numbers, which is 16. Now there are multiple ways of doing this. There is 2, 2, 2, 2, or you could take 3 ones and a 16. You could take 2 ones and a 2 and an 8. So there are many, many ways. However, I am taking just this. 2, 2, 2, 2. Why? It's not something random I'm doing. Think about it. If there's even one of these numbers that is equal to 1, say a plus 1 is equal to 1, then that would mean a is equal to 0. And if a is equal to 0, then when you come to the prime factorization, this part will become p1 to the power 0. That means it'll become 1. While I have to have 4 prime factors, that way I will lose p1 completely. I will lose the first prime factor. So none of these here can be equal to 1. And therefore, the only way I can break 16 down is this as 2 raised to the power 4. So I'm multiplying 2 with itself 4 times. With this, then I get the values of a, b, c, d as 1. So here is the complete prime factorization of x. Of course, I still don't know what these prime factors are. I don't know the values of p1, p2, p3, p4, but this is what it is going to look like. Now from this, I can get x to the power m. All I have to do is raise both sides to the power m. And when you do that in exponents, the powers get multiplied. So here, when a 1 gets multiplied by m, you get m only, and so all of these become m. Yet again, my question was to find the total factors, and I'll again rely on this one result. I know that I have to increase every power by 1 and I have to multiply them. So in my case, my powers are m each. So when I increase each of them by 1, they become m plus 1 each, and then I just have to multiply all the powers. So if I multiply m plus 1 with itself 4 times, what I get is m plus 1 to the power 4. So the final answer here for this problem is m plus 1 to the power 4, option D. Now I show you 2 more practice questions. So from this video, first of all, you start with the concept video. Then you come to this video where you solved one question with me. And then you're going to solve 2 more questions that I show you here for practice. We're not going to discuss the solutions yet, but the solutions will be available very soon. Here is question number 1. So we are given a number n, 5000, and we want to tell which of the following statements about n must be true. Statement 1 talks about the total number of factors that n has, which is something we discussed in this video, while statements 2 and 3 talk about the number of odd and even factors that n has. So this is taking the discussion that we had one step forward. So put your thinking caps on and think about this. Next question is a slightly harder one. It's a data sufficiency question where you are given that k is a positive integer greater than 1 and you want to find out the number of prime factors of 22k. What we have in the statements is some information about k. You have to analyze everything critically and take out as much as you can from each statement in your goal to finding the number of prime factors of 22k. As I said, the solutions to these will be up soon. Meanwhile, don't forget to comment your answers. Post your answers in the comments below before I submit mine. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for more great content like this. Happy learning!